In English words, two vowels occur consecutively and pronounced separately. These sounds are called diphones. For example, radio, E-O, real, E-A, real, real, real. Idea, I is a diphthong, E-A, I-D-A, E-A. So, two vowel sounds occur consecutively and pronounced separately. They are called diphones. You see, the word radio, when you pronounce this word radio, R-A-L-E-O, R-A, long vowel, A. This is just to indicate a line over the letter. Okay, just this indicates that it is a long vowel, because this A is there, here also A. So how to know? That is why we write a small dash over its head, and for this we will write a semicircle sign just to know that it is a short vowel. Okay, now come to this point. R consonant. R is a consonant. A vowel. R consonant sound. E vowel sound. O, this is vowel sound. While pronouncing this, radio, E-O, two vowels are occurring consecutively, one after the other. And also, they are separately pronounced. It is not a union. These two vowels, side by side they are coming, but they are not united. This pronunciation different, this pronunciation is different. There is no union like diphthong and one sound. No. Two separate sounds are being pronounced. See, re, li, I, o, separately pronounced. So, two vowels occurring consecutively and pronounced separately, this packing is known as diphone. Diphone. So, in the Greek language, di means two, double. Phone means sound. So two sounds, they have given their name. That's all. A suitable name. See, you know that English language itself is a composition of Latin, French, Greek, Sanskrit. So many language sounds are there in English. It is a composition of the sounds of several languages. Okay. So, we have taken this diphone. Diphone, because we cannot say it is a diphthong, because the diphthong is a union of two vowel sounds and two vowels are united and become one sound. I, O, I, U, like that. Here it is not like that. They are separate. They are pronounced separately. Re, di, I, O, I, O, I, O. They are not, you see, mixed together like diphthong sound, like mixing as water and milk. No, it is not like that. That means, you know, the black stones, they are mixed in rice. Black stones are mixed in rice. And rice and black stones are separately seen. Diphones are such type. They are separately seen. Okay. So, now, whenever there is a sound, what to do now? How to write? Because we write re, di. First, we write the consonants. Now, A, no problem. Re. Now, E, A, D. Now, O sound. That sign where we have to put which sound should be read and which sound should be read next. It is a difficult. So, there should not be any confusion. So, it then has created a different sign for such a situation, for such a sounds. So, iPhones are provided with angular signs again. But let us see their angles, how they will be. No, this is not possible. This is not possible to write. Both the vowel sounds occur after the, and we cannot put two vowel signs on one side. Therefore, there is a method. Let us see that method. there are two categories of dipoles. So Pittman has provided two different types of signs. Angular sign, light sign. This is called left angular sign. You know already diphthong signs. Similarly you can write. Okay, small, very small. The sign is called left angular sign because it is written with the left motion. That is the left angular sign. And this sign, right angular sign, this is left angular sign. So two categories, these two vowels occurring consecutively will come under two categories. Always in English words, diphonic sounds will come dot plus any other vowel, dash plus any other vowel. It will come like that. Let us see the method by which these angular signs are written, are used. You have now understood. I will give another example. Real, real, R-E-A-L. Now, R-E-A, E-A, separately pronounced. It is not real. If it is real, two vowel sounds are there, one vowel is only pronounced. E, where is E? Where is E? Real. I already told you that the spelling structure of the English word is not based on the sound that the word is pronounced. Therefore, it does not bother about the spelling. You observe the sound only. Here, spelling is different. E. Letter is provided E. So, here, only one vowel is there. E. But in this case, it is not like that. Re-a. E. Spelling is different. E. These two vowels occur. E, re, third place. Again, a occurred before you. Where to put? How can we put? So two vowels on the same side is not possible. It is now possible by using these signs. I will tell you how the use of these diphonic signs. What is the method of using these diphonic signs? I will tell you. Now you see the structure of the sounds. There is difference between a real and real. In the real, there is only one vowel sound, E. Understood? Real. There is only one vowel sound. Here, there are two vowels pronounced separately. Two different vowel sounds. I will tell you how it should be written. Now just I am giving an example how the sounds are there. What are diphonic sounds? Idea. You know, I-D. We can have the diphthong sign. Here diphthong has come, I. You see here, diphthong sound also has come. I, actually it is a water mixed milk. We cannot see what are those two sounds in this I. We cannot observe, isn't it? So there is only one sound, formed into one sound. So this is a diphthong sound. A very good example here. Now, here, I, A. This is a diphthong sound, but here, I, A, separately pronounced. Idea, I, D, I, A, idea. Consonant, I, D. Which one? Spelling is different. Spelling is different. E. Okay. E is represented by a night dot. A. Again, this is a short vowel. Just what I am putting. These signs are not connected with our shorthand system. In grammar, we show just to say that see, it is a short vowel. Otherwise, we will get confused if I don't put this. Because the same letters are given for long and short vowels. E, here also E. Whether it is short or long. So, it is short vowel. I think you have understood the point. These signs are not connected with our system. Okay. Just to know, it is when I put this, when I put this sign, you say it is a short vowel E. You see, this is the vowel E. A, short vowel again. A, light vowel. So two short vowels have come consecutively, one after the other. Same side two vowel signs, which should be read first? That is the confusion again. What I am telling is, in English words, two vowel sounds occur consecutively and pronounced separately. Such sounds, such a pack of sounds, such twins are called diphones. Now, I will give you another example. Now you read leak. Here, E, A is there, but it is sounded one vowel, E, long vowel. Same spelling here, separately pronounced in this word, idea. But whereas, in this word, even though E, A have come, they have come in a single sound. Here appeared as twins. Here appeared as single sound. Leak. So here, L, E, long vowel. Okay. That's all. Phonetic structure. E, long vowel. In English spelling structure, it will be different in different words. So, our task is now, if it is one single sound, there are signs. Dot, heavy dot, light dot, heavy dash, light dash. If the vowel sounds, two vowel sounds occur slowest. L, O, E, ist. S, L, O, E, ist. This can be represented by a small circle. L, O, O, heavy dash, long vowel, heavy dash, O, I put this sign, O, A, short vowel, A, so, short vowel, A, that is represented by a light dot. A. Stilu. We write stilu. We can use stilu. Now, combine this L. Slow. Then write the consonants first. Isn't it? Slow, fast. Now this O we can put to slow. Now what happened? Slowest. Slow, slowest. This is, oh, second place. Again, second place. A. If we put a dot here before another vowel sign, what will happen? What will happen? Aspirate. It will give the sound of head. Aspirate chapter. See. Huh? Ah. Dot head. Rule number 104. See the instructor. Now let us see how to use the diphonic signs. Now before that, I want to tell you one thing. Radio. Re vowel. This is the two vowels. We will have to see which is the first one. This is the first one and this is the second one. First vowel, second vowel. Okay. So, importance is given to the first vowel. First come, first serve. Isn't it? So, this E here. This is the one. The first vowel, not first place of it, first vowel. Here, this sign is placed. The first vowel and its original place. There, you put these signs. Let us see the examples. Once you see the examples, you will easily understand. Okay. Diphthongs are represented by small and light angular signs written in two directions. This is written in left direction. Therefore, it is called left angular sign. This angle, because it is forming an angle, therefore it is called angular sign. Okay. This is written with right direction. Therefore, it is known as right angular sign. So we use them for different categories or classes of words. Now, this is an important point. The diphthongic sign, either this or this, is written in the place of, the diphthongic sign is written in the place of first vowel of the two vowels. First vowel of the diphthong. First vowel of the two vowels occurred. See, radio. Now, when you pronounce it, this is the first vowel. This is called diphthong. Occurring consecutively and pronounced separately. Therefore, this is called diphthong. In this diphthong, there are two vowels. This is the first vowel and this is the second vowel. This is the first vowel and this is the second vowel. Okay. Now, that is the outline. Now, you can put re. No objection. A vowel. Isn't it? Long vowel and A. You put re. Now, D-O. E-O. For this, suppose this sign is allotted. Now, let us see which sign should be written. Now, for example, now you see this sign is allotted to this. Suppose this sign is to be written. Suppose. Now, this sign is written here or here because E-O. Two vowels are there. So, what is this first vowel of these two? This is the vowel. So, you put this sign here. Now, you need not put this. It is implied that there is O vowel has come. Once you put, you can easily read it. You need not put. This means that once you put this sign here, in which place? In which place? Third place. Easily you will get this sound, re, e. In the third place, e or e will come generally. So let us see. Just an example I will give. Which sign should be written? I will tell you. Just one. So my point is, these signs are placed in the place of the first vowel. Where it is written? Alone. When it stands alone, where do you put that vowel? There you will put this. So preference is given to the first vowel, not first place vowel. This is the third place vowel, E. Between these two. So the first vowel then stands alone. What is the place it occupies? Third place. There you put this sign. So the angular signs, the diphthongic sign is written in the place of the first vowel of the two vowels. What is the place in which the sign of the first vowel is written in that you put this angular sign, diphthongic sign. That's enough. You need not bother about the second vowel. This rule you should know. The diphonic sign is written in the place of first vowel of the two vowels. Observe the rules carefully. I told you, two categories of signs. This is called left angular sign, this is called right angular sign. The left angular sign is used to represent dot vowel plus any other vowel. Two vowels will occur, isn't it? The first vowel must be a dot vowel. The first vowel must be this dot vowel. Any one of these six. Dot vowel means a, e. Then the second vowel, any one of the other 11 vowels. The first vowel to use this sign. To use the left angular sign, the condition is the first vowel must be any one of the vowels represented by the dot. The second vowel may be one of the remaining 11 vowels. Saib, that is the proper name. Here, Saib, A-I, two vowels. The first vowel, the second vowel. Say this. Dot vowel. The first one is there. The first one is a dot vowel. Sa I. So a dot vowel plus any other vowel. This is a consonant. This is consonant. These are consonants. We are dealing with vowels. Now let us see. This is represented by a circle. B. Okay. Now this is a when it stands alone, where do you put? Here. This a. How do you read it? This plus a. Isn't it? This is the place. So in this place you put this sign. You read it is. Immediately, first place, A. Whether long or short, you simply immediately will come. Sir. 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 You know the word. Sir. Immediately, you will read this. Sir. So you have placed this sign in the place of first vowel when it stands alone, where does it sit? There you have written the angular sign. Let us see the other examples. Layer. It is not consonant. A. Second place. This is the first one. This is the second one. First vowel and second vowel. Layer. A. Layer. Now, A when stands alone, second place vowel. Where do you put? Here. Isn't it? If you want to put this vowel here, you will put, isn't it? A. Now, there is another, this is a silent letter. This is a silent letter. Don't bother about this Y. Y has no sound. A. So what is the place? Second place. Then this is represented by dot. Therefore, dot plus any other vowel. You put surveyor. Survey. See this animals have a sar, sar, su. You read first, su, a, then ar, sar, then u. Next, a, next, a, and there. So, let us not bother about this sound. Automatically it will come, surveyor. English noun, surveyor. Survey. Which angular sign? Left angular sign. This depends that here dot vowel has come. Because angular sign, left angular sign, dot. Once if you identify this, survey, that's a or a, it will come. So, surveyor. Lady. L, A, E. First vowel, second vowel. This first vowel, you must immediately catch whether it is a dot vowel or dash vowel. It is a dot. L, A. Immediately the second one is E. Let us not bother. Once you recognize this as a dot vowel, first one is a dot vowel, immediately you imagine this left angular sign. Okay. So this sign, left angular sign, is to be written. Where, what is the first vowel's place? What is the place of the first vowel here? You put that. Le-i-ti. That's all. So, le-i-ti, just an enlarge. That's all. Le, I, le, I. However, because two vowels are diphones, because two vowels occurred consecutively. Le, I, le, I, T, le, I, T. Le, I. Real. I, A. I, A. I, A. First vowel, I. Real. E-A. E-A. First, E. Where do you put? Here. Dot vowel. So which sign? Left angular sign. E. Real. Real. So left angular sign is used because this is represented by a dot. Therefore, dot plus any other vowel. This sign should be used. Radio. R-A-I-D-E-O. Radio. E-O. E is a dot vowel. Therefore, immediately you can imagine left angular sign should be used. Then where to put re, di, re, this vowel sign, re, e, id, e, o. When stands alone, e is written in the third place here. There you put this angle. That's enough. So automatically, o is implied. O sound is implied. Radio. Radio. Diphone. A very good example. Radio. Like this, you first catch the first vowel of the diphone. If it is a dot vowel, write the left angular sign. Where did you put that first vowel? There you put this angular sign. Junior. E A. Junior. You see? Zoo. Zoo. Now you see. Here, nar we have written. So, intervening vowel between the hook and the stroke. Rule. Tell me the rule. Huh? Intervening vowel between the hook and the stroke. Rule number 75. Pitman Chardin, Inspector. The cure. Isn't it? Huh. This is left angular sign. This left angular sign should be placed like this. You see? That means ER junior ER has occurred between the hook and the stroke. Nerve. Junior. Healthier. Healthier. Decay. Decay. Healthier. Hell. Only A. Hell. Hell. E. A. Two vowels. E. A. Healthier. E. First of all, E. Dark vowel. Therefore, left angular sign. Now, this has occurred third. It's so, hook and we have used initial hook. Alternative forms. Again, rule number 75. That is held here. You can put here like this. Left angular sign. Held here. G O E O. So what is the first vowel diphthong? E O. Two vowels occurred consecutively. E O. What is the first vowel? E. E. O. Let us not bother about. First vowel, what is that? E. In the diphthong, you always observe the first vowel of the two vowels. E, it is a dark vowel. Therefore, left angular sign should be used. The first vowel E is third place. So it is actually written in third place. So put G-O-F-E. Write the first consonant sounds. G. Isn't it? So there you put third place. The third place vowel occurring between two strokes is written before the second stroke at the end. Isn't it? You will put here. Now because this is a diphonic sign, you put. It means that third place vowel is occurring. Is plus E automatically O will come. Because the other consonants will give the clue. Geography. Geography. G-O-G-R-A-P-H-Y. Geography. Diphonic sound. For dash plus any other vowel, right angular sign is used. Drawing. O-E. O E. Immediately we write the right angular sign. Drawing. Drawing. Let it draw. First person. Oh. First sounded vowel. It is the first place vowel. And it is the first place vowel. Oh. O is the when it stands alone, it is written here. So there you put. Draw E. This is first vowel, this is second vowel. Oh, first vowel, E, second vowel. Now, very easy. Oh, E, drawing. That's all. Two vowels occurred here. Two vowels represented here by right angle. Draw, oh, dash vowel. Plus any other vowel. PH. First vowel, second vowel. What is the first vowel? Pa. Sound is A. O. Correspondingly, O it must be. So, that lesser shade. O. O. Pa. Dash vowel. After that, A. Pa.
speedily pronounced. Perfect. Dash or Bersenio Rover. What is the angular sign? Immediately, we can imagine right angular sign. Where this should be placed? What is the place in which this, when stands alone, the written second place? So, CT. Here, second place, right angular. Right angular means dash O plus any other word. Second place O or O. Point. Point. Automatically it will come. On the line, point. Coincide. Hear this sound clearly. Co-E. O-E. Inside. Coincide. Co-E. Co-inside. Co. The first vowel is O. Dash vowel. O. Dash vowel. Immediately, we can imagine that the right angular sign. Plus any other vowel. E has come. Let us not bother. Second place. Then, it stands alone. Where do you put this O? Second place. Put here. Co. Automatically, E will come. Any other vowel means any of the remaining 11 vowels. Automatically it will come. Because we are familiar with these words, this remaining consonants suggest the sound. Coincide. Co-in. This I. First place. First place. Let us accommodate. I. It is not second place. First place only. Let us accommodate. Coincide. What is the position? What position? Oh, second place vowel. If the first sounded vowel is a second place vowel, the outline is written in second position, that is on the line. The first upstroke or downstroke indicates the position of the outline. What is the first upstroke or downstroke? Such D. D. Therefore, D should be on the line. So it should be on the line. Slowest. Slowest. O. A. O. A. Dash vowel. Any other vowel. So, slowest. Right angular sign. Heroic. Hero. Heroic. See? O. E. Again. O. Dash vowel. Plus any other vowel. Heroic. This one. He. O. Ik. E. Is implied here. Heroic. Right angular sign. Because dash plus any other vowel. First vowel. This is the first vowel is the dash vowel. Second vowel automatically is implied. This is a very good example. Jewel. This W has no sound at all. So remaining is Ju. This gives the sound of U. A. So U plus any other vowel. Dash vowel plus any other vowel. Therefore, right angular sign. U. Ju L. Through the U. See, letter is different, sound is different. Ju, L. Here E. But this E gives the sound of U, Ju, L. Like this, two categories of words are there. For two categories, we got two different angular signs. Dot plus any other vowel, left angular sign. For dash plus any other vowel, right angular sign is used. This diphonic signs also can be used in a very small class of words where it is not exactly diphonic sound but it appears to be diphonic sound. For example, question, 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 question. You hear this one, question. So, for such sounds also, let us make use of this angular sign. The first sound is very clear, first she, he. So dot, dot plus any other vowel. So, correct? Left angular sign. Dot plus any other vowel. Boolean. E. So, left angular sign. Bo. Left hand sign. Boolean. So, in such a small class of words also, we can use the angular sign. Such a sounds also will be treated as diphones. So like this, the diphones are written.